starting off the video, some 4 or 5 squats. Get a side angle for the haters, man. Right. People on the internet, man. Damn, no song. That's all right.
Let's go, one more. Easy.
Begin the video. Last set, 3 reps, 5th set.
Let's go, Max.
This is, I used to like go to roller skating rinks and do this. Oh my goodness.
This is a jam, bro. Let's go. One more. Up. Easy.
So, one good thing, you guys have been seeing Johnny a lot in my videos, especially when I do edits, because he's the shred out of everyone. But he was the one who trained, or he competed at the same powerlifting meet as me. Back in like June, was it?
Yeah.
And it's cool because he trains a lot for my bodybuilding hypertrophy, but he also has a powerlifting side to him, and he's very, very strong. So it's cool training with someone else who has very similar strength levels and wants to get strong as hell, unlike everyone else. After squats, bench. Question. I'm sitting, tapping my back when I turn around. Tell me if it looks like I have a wiener on my back, my sweat. Yeah. Does it look like I have a wiener?
You got that
BBC on your back. I don't know. Alright, so it's like 9:15. There's no one else here. Check this out. Johnny, who I was lifting with, he gave me these shoes for like a late birthday present. He had bought them because they were on sale and then they're too big for him. I think these are Nike Roshes? Roches, very cool, very, very comfortable. Thanks, Johnny. I'm gonna hit Chick-fil-A. One thing people have been asking about when the compression pants are coming out, so these are actually the brand new sample with updated fabrics and compression soon. I'm working on a full restock. I have a bunch of, like my fabric booklets over there, so working on some new designs, new colorways, just a lot of stuff. There should be a huge launch before the end of the year. And the compression pants will probably come sooner. If any of you are like large, I need to order less larges, but if any of you are larges or like extra small, extra large, if you go to the Everford Apparel, the first batch, which some of you may not know, but basically they're just leggings. They're not necessarily compression pants. They're really nice, but they're just not as compression as I wanted to. So if you want a pair of discounted ones, I still have a few left, but yeah. I'm working on it, guys. Don't eventually. But I'm gonna go get some Chick-fil-A, and then I'm gonna come back and do some work probably until, I don't know, like 11:30 or something? Then I'll head home. So I'll move to the other
side of the block so we won't ever have to. How come Chick-fil-A made
Serbia.
Hi, can I have a spicy chicken sandwich combo on a multigrain bun? And I'll take a half unsweet tea, half diet lemonade to drink. And then can I also add a 12-piece nugget? So the Arnold Palmer from Chick-fil-A, half unsweet tea, half diet lemonade, or the diet Arnold Palmer. Like, it's so good, but what if they're like, oh, what drink did he want? Half lemonade, half regular tea, right? And they just made it regular. I would never know because it's so delicious. They could give me all those calories. Those are the real things that I fear.
That kick.
So Peter and Omar were going over some footage. If you guys didn't know, the gym, District Barbell, has their own YouTube channel, which these guys film, so it's
a little bit like behind mine in terms of content, like timing, but it's just like different footage. So if you want more of everyone and a little bit of dumb Max thrown in,
here's an example clip from the video that's about to go up.
Things that he won't show on his channel.
So if you guys want to go subscribe, type this into YouTube. I'll put a link in the description. Just go click it and you can see all this. Actually, I don't know if anyone wants to see that.
Good morning. So like in previous videos, I've been saying that I haven't really been like doing much in my apartment because I know you guys haven't seen my apartment in a while, but I'll show you it. It's a mess. Look at this. This is actually embarrassing. Like what is this? Is this real life? This will all be cleaned up very, very soon. You guys are watching this on Thursday. On Friday, I have a special guest coming into town, staying with me until Tuesday. So I got to clean up before then. I also have not been eating cereal because I don't have any, which is really upsetting. So you guys know I love my cereal, but I also haven't made the shake in a while, but I'm gonna make this morning. One serving of peanut butter, two servings of Quick Oats, two servings of milk. I have some ice in there. I have banana in there. I would normally have spinach, but I don't have any. Two servings of Ghost cereal Milk Whey, which I guess is about as close as I can get to cereal in my shake. And then I'm going to eat this apple because delicious. But you guys currently aren't missing much in my apartment because I wake up. I make some sort of breakfast usually. I shower so I can do this hair, except when I get my hat, right? That I won't need to do my hair and I'll be so cool looking. And I do some orders, whatever orders from the previous day of Everforward. And then I go to the gym because there's lots of work that needs to be done and it's not gonna get done unless we do it. So let's go do it. So one thing I'm kind of excited for when the gym is finally done is that I don't necessarily need to wear like gym clothes every single day to the gym because I'll be working there a lot. But right now I just wear gym clothes because we get pretty grimy and dirty while we're fixing up that old building. But at least I can wear my cool sunglasses to block out the haters, right? These are Movement, by the way. Same company that makes watches, they also make sunglasses. These are polarized and these are only like 90 bucks. Got some Clubmasters as well. Tortoiseshell, we are like basically turtles up in here. Tortoiseshell is the coolest. If you guys are interested, this link is always in the description. You can use Max10 to save yourself 10% on the already cheap, pretty cool sunglasses. Okay, heading to get my Jeep washed. Got to set up an appointment to get the rear quarter panel. The other day they called me, they're like, yeah, we can't find the rattle. I was like, yeah, I know, I could have showed you it while I was there. Then they went back and looked at it more. They're like, it's not even the cell that's rattling, it's the quarter panel. I'm like, I know that. Dang it. So they had to order a quarter panel. I have to go set up an appointment to get that fixed so it doesn't rattle anymore. So I can bump some Drake slow jams. All right, let's go. Oh, the camera's slipping. Ah.
All right, so very sad day at the gym. This is for the gym's reputation to be hardcore, to be taken serious. Others. This had to happen. I'm sorry that you guys had to see it go, but it was a tough choice. Is that a good thumbnail out there?
It's a great thumbnail.
Taking a break from the ceiling tiles, going to grab a drink, maybe some candy. What do you think so far in the gym? All the work we've been doing.
It's a lot of work, but like,
you think it's gonna be worth it, man?
It's worth it, man. But when you go back and look at where it first started and where it is now.
That's not to say, I'm sure we'd rather just have had to do no work, but it will be cool. All this bullshit that we're going through that, you know, 4 or 6 months down the road, we'll look back and be like, damn, we forgot to do that. Ooh.
Dang, it doesn't do it. I'll do it. Okay. Wait, 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 oh yeah.
Wait.
Got it. That's how you do it right there.
I clang them.
Go next. Yeah. Ooh. Just like the G, you know? So
hot. Come on, man.
Be falling into it.
Let's go. Oh, I'm gonna snap my shit up if I keep going.
So I brought my soundbar from my home. You know, and I was thinking if I wired these speakers into it, I just wanted to see if those, we have speakers in the ceiling, but I don't think that they work or something. Or they need an actual receiver, but I would imagine this sub would act as a receiver and power them, but we're just gonna pull those speakers out of the ceiling because they're probably super old. And then we'll figure out where we're going to put the sound bar, make sure it sounds the best, put the speakers, these satellite speakers up in the corners, and then, you know, we'll just jam out, guys. So, disco balls over there. Showing the giant disco balls.
Peter's learning how to focus on the camera, so. Yeah, zoom and. Bam!
Cool. Alright. We are admitting defeat on the wiring of these fans. Unfortunately, I know ceiling fans are so easy to do. Can't believe you guys didn't do them, but it's just a big pain in the ass right now. We spend like so many hours because they're wired together, like where one is the main power. I don't even know how to word it correctly. It's just really frustrating. It's not like your everyday. It's not like installing a ceiling fan in your ceiling in your room or something. So we're gonna get some help with that, no problem. And I am tightening up the ceiling fan bracket, and then once we turn the lights back on, I'll show you how the entire ceiling is completely 99.9% done with all brand new tiles.
Are you recording too?
Yeah, bro.
Can you see me?
Yeah, I can see you. I can see your shirt too. Not like all the way, like I can't see a nipple or anything.
I can see down your shirt! Wait, who's that from? Joe Dirt?
I was gonna say, well, or. Never mind.
Yeah, just like. This, everything above this drop ceiling is like super annoying. It's like, none of it's like sick roof up here, dude. It's more like, God, this is super lame and annoying, and they ghetto rigged everything.
I'm so sick and tired of like doing all this like time consuming stuff that is just like fixing it. Like it's cool to have like this story about how we took a gym that was literally a piece of crap, supposed to be a piece of crap. The fact that we had to replace all the ceiling tiles because they were just grungy says enough in itself, but like I keep saying, 6 months down the road, it's gonna be crazy to look back and see the progress that we've made. And also, we always have to remember, no matter how much money we spend on renovations, we saved like $6,000 to $8,000 on mirrors. Always remember that. Always remember that. So, that's the whole roof. Ceiling is pretty much done. The only ones we have to do, why don't we have a tile on that one? Is there a reason, or once we shut these cords up? Mm-hmm. All right, we gotta put one tile there, and then over here there was no center bracket, so we need to buy a little T bracket just to go in the middle of that and put two squares there. And then the only other issue one is the one where there was the leak, which they came and looked at, and they're like, we didn't see the leak. They're like, okay, well, it's there. So they're gonna come back and worry about that. And we'll put a tile there, but that's it, people. That took about a week to do.
Wait, what?
To do the ceiling?
Yeah, dude, it took like 2 weeks.
How much does it cost for, you think, all the ceiling tiles? Because they're They come in packs of eight.
Yeah.
And they're, how much are they a box?
30 a pack, 35 a pack.
So $35 for eight pieces, which is like not that much, right? But when you have 150 easily.
It's a lot. It adds up.
That's, if I'm saying, carry the seven common denominator.
You're Asian, do the math.
It's $17,428. I think that's right.
Wait, 17,000?
I'm kidding, dude!
Sounds about right.
But ceiling is pretty much done. RIP disco balls. I'm actually gonna get a thumbnail now for the video where I'm holding these two, what looks like balls, because they actually are. People are gonna be like, you know, Max, that was the only thing that made your gym unique and you took it down. You know, unsubscribing, but. Sometimes in life, guys, you just gotta grab life by the disco balls. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So with replacing all those tiles, the floor is absolutely filthy. As you can see, I've been sweeping up some piles, but it's very, very dusty, so we need to completely sweep it. Then I think we're gonna scrub it and mop it and make sure it's all shiny in time for the equipment. So that's where we'll pick up on the next video. Again, I do have a special guest coming on Friday evening. Something you've never seen on my channel before, I don't think. Or at least not in a collab hangout type of way. So get excited for that. Hit the thumbs up button, please. And thumbs up for no super wrong issues in this video, right? But I think the ceiling looks fantastical. Now we're gonna clean the mats. There is like a potential hurricane coming on Saturday, so hopefully we get the equipment early morning before the rain and or hurricane comes. But that's that. That'll conclude this video. Every single day, guys. The gym gets a little bit better every single day. Also, thank you guys for like the positive feedback you've been giving on this series. So, lots more to come. Leave your questions down below in terms of like what you specifically want to see. I know that I'm gonna do some Q&As about opening a gym. I'm gonna talk about how much money we've spent. I'm gonna talk about like things that I wish were different, kind of things like that. So, still many more episodes coming in the series. Make sure you've seen them all. Thank you guys, long outro, goodbye.